Hi there, this is Ranjit from tech2bus.com, and in this video I'm going to compare a traditional hard drive with a SSD on a Windows 7 computer. I'm going to do some tests where you can determine the efficiency of a SSD over a hard drive. For the test, I'll be using a Kingston 96GB SSD that works on the SATA 2 interface, and the hard drive that I'll use is a Seagate 7200 RPM hard drive, and the processor that's running on the test computer is a Core i7 running at 3.4 GHz with 4 GB of RAM, and it's loaded with Windows 7 32-bit edition. The first thing we'll have a look at is the Windows experience, and this is with the traditional 7200 RPM hard drive, and you can see that the primary hard disk, the score that we are getting is 5.3. And now this is the score that we get with our SSD. Let's look at the primary hard drive, and the score that we get with the SSD is 7.2. This is a popular benchmarking software for the hard drive. Let me give you an overview of this. And this shows how the hard drive performs in MB per second. And as we can see, this is with the traditional hard drive. The minimum data transfer speed that we got while benchmarking was about 65 MB. And the maximum that we got was 124 MB, and the average was 102 MB. As you can see, the performance is not consistent. It gradually degrades a bit over time. So remember, the average that we got was 102 MB with the traditional hard drive. Now replacing it with the SSD, let's look at the performance. Now, this is the same benchmarking software. Now, that is with the Kingston 96GB SSD. And as you can see, the performance is nearly consistent throughout the benchmark. And let's go over the readings. And the minimum transfer rate that we got was about 126 MB, and the maximum was 212. But look at the average that we got. That's 193 MB. And have a look at the access time. It's just 0.1 milliseconds. And for the traditional hard drive, it was around 15 milliseconds. Now I want to demonstrate the performance of your computer, how it degrades when there is a lot of hard drive activity. It's not uncommon in Windows to run the antivirus scan in the background, and I'm going to do the same and then start launching a bunch of programs, and we'll see how it affects the performance. The first thing, I'll be doing it with the traditional hard drive and then with the SSD. Now I'm starting the AVAST antivirus scan, and the good thing about AVAST antivirus scan is that we can actually see what is the speed at which it's scanning the disk. Currently it's scanning at around 14 to 18 MB per second. Now what I'm going to do is, now I'm going to launch the Firefox browser. I've clicked on the same, and as you can see, it is taking considerable time to launch the Firefox browser. It has finally launched the same. What I'm going to do is now go to the YouTube page. The AVAST antivirus is still going on in the background, and I'm going to play one of my videos. Let's play this video, how to install SSD in your computer, and I'm going to play it at 480p. As you can see, the performance is a bit sluggish. And I'm going to mute this. Now I'll let this video continue. And what I'm going to do is now, I'm going to launch the Chrome browser. As you can see, the video is playing in the background. I've launched the Chrome browser. And as you can see, it's taking a while for it to launch the Chrome browser. The antivirus scan is still running. And now finally the Chrome browser is loaded, and as you can see, it took considerable time for it to load the Chrome browser. Now I'm going to go to tech2bus.com, and it has loaded the site tech2bus.com, but still the performance is a little bit sluggish. And finally, what I'm going to do is, still the antivirus scan is running in the background, and it's touching around 20 MB now. I'm going to launch the Internet Explorer 1, 2, and 3. And as you can see, it's again taking a while for it to load Internet Explorer. We'll wait till the page loads, the default MSN page. And again, as you can see, it's taking a considerable amount of time. And many people think that this delay is due to the fact that they don't have enough processing power in your computer, but that's not the case. It's because in such scenarios, the traditional hard drive is the bottleneck. As when there is heavy disk activity, the traditional hard drive is just not able to cope up. And in such scenarios, if you try to multitask, you'll take a performance hit. Now we are doing the same test with an SSD, Kingston SSD. This is a Kingston 96GB SSD. And we're going to scan the C drive. And as you can clearly see that the first thing is, the scan is averaging at around 80 MB. With the traditional hard drive, we were touching about 12 to 15 MB. And now I'm going to launch Firefox browser. I've clicked it and you can easily see that it has instantly launched. The antivirus scan that's running in the background, it's not affecting the performance of the other applications. We're going to do the same. We're going to start this playing this video. We'll play it in. And as you can see, it immediately played and there is no delay or anything like that. The antivirus scan is still running in the background and it's approximately about 75 MB. Now what I'm going to do is launch the Chrome browser and you can see instantly it launches. We'll go to Tech2Bus. And it loads the site. We'll click this link. And the browsing is smooth. There's no problem with that. And as you can see, still the antivirus scan is running. It has slowed down a bit to about 68 MB. Now what I'm going to do is launch the Internet Explorer and it's going to open MSN. As you can see, it has clearly launched it way faster. What I wanted to demonstrate is that under heavy multitasking and when there is heavy load on the hard drive, how a SSD performs. The SSD performs way better than a hard drive. And your performance of your computing will not degrade with an SSD. Also do note that with the traditional hard drive, we were averaging around 15 MB of transfer. And with the SSD, it's doing about 70. So the antivirus scan will be finished about 5x faster on an SSD. For this portion of the test, what I have done is I have set Windows 7 to launch 7 programs when it boots up. The 7 programs are, one is a Word document, one is an Excel file, one is a PDF document, the Chrome browser, the Firefox browser, Internet Explorer and Paint.net application. What you'll see is 2 windows, one is for the SSD and one is running Windows 7 on the traditional hard drive. And I'll be starting both of them at the same time and you can see how fast the SSD loads all the 7 programs compared to the hard drive. Both the SSD and HD starts and the SSD is already loading the programs and the SSD has already finished loading all the programs and the hard drive hasn't even started. Excel is just starting to load up now. Let me just remove the SSD window and zoom into the hard drive window. Chrome browser starts to load. Internet Explorer also starts to load. And now the Google Chrome browser loads.
And Word is also done. Firefox and Paint still needs to load. Paint has loaded. Fox set reader also, PDF has loaded. Still Firefox hasn't loaded. Waiting for Firefox.
Now finally the Firefox browser loads and all the programs even on the hard drive are loaded now. For the hard drive it took about 1 minute 8 seconds to load all the programs and for the SSD it took 6 seconds to load all the programs. If you found this video helpful, I'll appreciate if you click on the like button given below. That's it for now. This is Ranjit for Tech2Bus.com and hopefully I'm going to see you in my next video.